Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to discuss about a very common issue that many of my students are facing while installing WAMP Server. See, so all these Visual C++ packages, it is telling not installed. And because of that, we are unable to install WAMP Server. So how to resolve this issue? So that is what I am going to show you on this video itself. So do watch the video till the end and also follow us on our Instagram. And if you're still facing any issues, you can always ask me on comment sections. So now to resolve this issue, you can see it is already telling to go to this wamserver.aviotechno.net, right? And from there, we need to download all these different missing packages and we need to install that. All right. So let's go to this wamserver.aviotechno.net website. So go to your favorite browser and just simply type wamserver.aviotechno.net. Just Google it and go to their official site. So this link I'm going to provide on our description. So you can use that link from our description to land over here. Once when you are here, you need to scroll down and you will see these sections, right? So here you again go back to your error message and see which are all packages are missing currently. So currently I have only these three packages missing. In your case, you might see 4 or 5 packages missing. So whatever packages are missing, you need to download that. So I'll start from the first one, that is Visual C++ 2012 x86. So if I come over here, you can see there are two columns, right? One is x86, that is 32-bit, and another is x64, that is 64-bit. So if you go to the error message again, you can see we need to download Visual C++ 2012 x86. So 2012 x86, so it has to be under x86 column and it is Visual C++ 2012. Just simply click on that and let's download that package. You can see it is rightly downloaded, right? So similar way, but the next thing that is missing is Visual C++ 2010 sp1, but this time it is x64, so we need to download that x64. So just come over to this x64 column and we need to download 2010 SP1. So 2010 SP1, see we have a package over here. So just simply click on that and we are going to download that as well. Next thing that you will need is Visual C++ 2012 and this time it is x64 again. So 2012 x64. So this is x64 column and 2012. So this one, click on that and we are going to have that also. Alright, so currently I have only these three missing, so I need to download it and I need to install that. So in your case, it could be four packages missing or 5 or 6 packages missing even. Alright, so whichever packages are missing, you need to just, you know, download it from either x86 or x64 depending upon the package that is missing. So just download that and install it. So I have all these three downloaded, I'll install it. So I'll first minimize my browser, I'll first click on OK over here and click on cancel. Yes, I'll go to my download directory and you can see all these three packages are rightly downloaded. Let's install it one by one. We'll start from the first one. I'll accept the license agreement. It will ask if I administered the privileges, click on yes. And you can see that it is rightly installed. So setup is successful, click on close. Next I need to install the second one, so just double click on this package, click on yes to provide administrative privileges, accept the license agreement, click on yes, install, and you can see our installation is also rightly done. So complete, click on finish. Next we'll install the third one, so just double click on it, accept the license agreement, install, relax if I administer the privileges, click on yes, and that is also rightly done. So all the three missing packages are now rightly installed. So now we are good to install our WAMP server. So I'll just simply double click on the WAMP server exe. It's going to ask if I administer the privileges, click on yes, and there you go. Just simply click on OK over here. So accept the license agreement, click on next, and click on next again. This time you see we are not getting any error, right? Because we have installed all the missing packages. So now we are good to install WAMP server. Alright, So in this way, I can easily resolve all these errors and you are good to install WAMP Server. If you further want to know how to install the remaining steps of WAMP Server installation, you can always watch this video. So this video, I wanted to resolve this error. So that's pretty much all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Script and Geeky Syntax channel. And also I am posting a lot of videos on WordPress, so if you're interested, you can always watch this tutorial. So some videos are 1 hour videos, some are 1 hour 30 minute video. So you can always watch this entire playlist to learn more about WordPress. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.